Hello there, folks. Today I'm gonna come back to cover another theme, as I said, in a short series of videos regarding self-development and the idea of discovering yourselves and having a better grasp of who you are. So today I found a few ideas regarding the feeling fine fact. Many people, when you ask them how they are, they actually say they are fine. And thankfully I have found this little picture to support me. Whenever you ask people, you know, even your friends, relatives, close ones, or even strangers, usually when you ask them how they feel, how they are, they usually say that they are fine, that they are doing fine in life, everything is fine. Usually this word can be taken as an acronym, and it would stand for, fearful and insecure, you know, neurotic, emotional. I like it how this word is created out of so many words, because these are what lie beyond what people say fine. The purpose of my videos is to present a better sight, or to show more insight of the subconscious and how it works, and how people say actually shows more than they intend to say. Because usually people always say the truth, but the way they say it is not consciously perceivable always as being the truth. Because when someone says they're fine, they might pretend to be so, but they're still telling the truth, because deep down inside they are feeling at least some of these aspects. So if you're saying that you're fine, you're most likely feeling down. So the question is, are you really feeling down? So let's dive into it. What could be a few factors that could point you to feeling down? Do you have negativistic people around, people who pull you down? Is your environment toxic? Like, what are you surrounded by? Also, don't forget, and I would really ask you to read something, at least a bit, on the pendulum effect. I will create a video on this at another time. So everything that you think of, especially in the room that you spend most time in, everything that you think of will remain in that room as a cloud. So whenever you hit that same vibration of those thoughts that you have manifested into your room, be they of anger, of hatred, self-repulsion, or even of love, when you hit that repulsion again, it's gonna pop those things back up. That's why you'll have that impression that they won't get off your mind. They won't, and most likely they are not in your mind, most likely not even in your auric field, but being around you, you'll pick them up. Have you ever been in different areas of town and had different lower vibrations, and suddenly you are met with different thoughts you wouldn't think of? You know? Like, you don't ever drink, but suddenly you have this thought creeping up? Well, you pick that up from somewhere else. Have you ever been in some kind of crossroads in your car, right, and you suddenly have a fear that you might suffer a car crash? That's a case in which you absorbed, actually you connected to the vibration of a thought that was existent there. Previously, someone or many more people thought of this at that place, or probably they witnessed an accident some other time in their life and they manifested that fear right there. So if you're feeling down, it is definitely a sign that you are having toxic people who are draining you. Don't forget, many people will do everything to gain your attention, and where your attention goes, your energy will flow. There's also another quote that says, "Show me your closest 5 people and I can predict you the future." Also, the same quote says, "I can also say who you are." It is said that usually we tend to become the people we spend most time with, so you should try focusing on more successful people. Find a few things that you want to do in life, like improve on your hobbies, heighten those skills, and try following people who actually do that. Don't focus on your problems, because mostly are either invented in our life or they are augmented by our, you know, habit of putting ourselves down, and focus on the little blessings that you have in your life. Focus on everything that makes you a normal person, that you have all four limbs, because others might be missing one at least. Focus on being healthy. Focus on more things. Positivity, in a way, doesn't make you feel necessarily better. In most cases, it's like emotional masturbation, because it makes you theoretically feel good, but if you don't work anything towards your life, you'll just remain fine. Okay, so hope that helps. In order to prevent yourself from feeling fine, let's see some of these terms. Okay, so usually when you feel broken or useless, it's what Bruce Lee said: defeat is only a state of mind. You can only be defeated when you accept it. Okay, so when you feel broken and useless, they are kind of the same thing. It's because you had expectation in people. If you want to not feel fine and feel good in life and no longer feel drained, start not placing too much emphasis on expectation. Just don't expect things from people. Only expect things from people whom you can trust, and even if it sounds enough, even if it sounds hard, these people are not hard to find. It's all about mentality. If you think that they are hard to find, you'll have a hard time finding them. Most likely, you'll have a feeling of loneliness. So, don't expect, if you're falling apart, don't expect people to notice it. I've seen this in my time, in my life. I've had internal struggles for a very long time, and my family couldn't notice it. They just manifested for years as if everything is fine. Everything is alright. There's no problem with me. So, don't expect things from people. If there is something to fix, you fix it. At rare cases, if you need help, you can ask for it, but try doing things your own way. You know, then never forget, some people's truth might not be the truth for you. And hopefully this kind of covers the idea. I will make other videos, because I intend this series to be really short. Have an awesome day. Never forget, life is awesome, and so are you. Also, you are loved and appreciated. Whatever you are doing is more than good enough, is the best you can at the right pace for you. So don't try to overdo things, because you'll end up feeling overburned, you'll end up feeling burnt, overtired, and that will make you feel very bad. Also, when you're making objectives, try making a very short list, and out of that list, focus on the first or second, like the first one or two most important things, and then only then do the other ones. Okay, so make a list, because if you try to do a lot of things in a day, you will focus on a few, and you know how we tend to. We will always focus on what we have failed rather than seeing and noting what we have achieved. Have an awesome day, and thanks for watching.